Do you want to play PlayStation 2 games on your Android phone? Then you're going to learn how to do this by the end of this video tutorial. Stay tuned. Yo, what up guys, TechSecPro with Android time. A lot of people want to experience this nostalgic console, PlayStation 2, and I bet you too. And in this video, I'm going to teach you how to emulate PS2 console on your Android phone to play different games on it. Well, basically, I tested different PS2 emulators for Android and they were kind of like buggy, and some of them even couldn't fire up the games from the get-go on my phone. But this time, it really worked on my phone and I'm going to showcase you how to do this for sure. You just need to have the game and the app. That's it, guys. First off, you gotta transfer game to your Android phone storage. The game I'm gonna play is Capcom vs. SNK2. So I connect my phone to laptop by USB cable and transfer the game to the root folder of my phone. Now open up Google Play Store and search for PS2 emulator. Nope, don't get me wrong, I'm not gonna go for the first one. I go for the second one, which is Play, developed by Virtual Applications team. Download and install it. This app is still under active development and will provide updates to fix issues and bugs. Great. Open it up. You should give access to SD card that app can read data from it. Here's the user interface, which is really friendly, and one of the cool things that this app has is that you don't need the BIOS file for PlayStation 2 at all. Here's the game I already transferred, and as you can see, even the thumbnail is downloaded. Let's get into the menu and see options. In settings, we got both emulator and user interface settings. In emulator settings, you can enable disable FPS that shows at which frame rate per second your game is running. Display on screen virtual gamepad that you can just play games by touching buttons on screen. Cap frame rate that helps weaker phone to run games faster. In video settings, we got GS handler that you can switch between OpenGL or Vulkan depending upon the performance of your phone's video graphic unit. Resolution factor that you can set it up to 8 times maximum. You can resize the games with square pixel aspect ratio to 16:9 wide screen by this option if you wish so. Force bilinear filtering, which can smooth out the textures in the game. Presentation mode, which you can set it up to full screen, fit screen, and original size. Last but not least is audio output that you can enable or disable the game sound. Back to main menu, UI settings. Rescan storage. Scans your whole storage for games. Every time you open this app, it scans your phone to add new games in the list, but if there was a problem, you can use this option to fix it. Clear unavailable games. For instance, when you added games in the list and later you delete them but still are shown in the list, you can just remove them by this option to fix your list. Reset cache, which will clear game's thumbnail if it's not wanted or even wrong cover. Migrate data file that moves the data folder from the device as it is mentioned. And we got theme selection that you can simply choose it based on your taste and they immediately apply when you select them. Alrighty, that was the whole settings and options. So let's run and play Capcom vs. SNK2 PlayStation 2 game on my Android phone. Here is the virtual gamepad on the screen, and here it is. You know, guys. Running the PS2 games on your Android depends on two factors, software and hardware. But this app is working like a charm. Of course, I told you at the beginning, it's under the development and stuff. It's still giving you updates, so to fix the issues and bugs. If you got the new cell phone, I think the game is gonna run smoother and better, you know what I'm saying? So depends on the model of your cell phone, if it's new or old, this app trying to adapt itself. But keep it in your mind that not all the PS2 games are supported by the virtualization, so you gotta just check the list of the compatibility on the internet and understand which game is more actually smooth to run on the PS2 virtualization or PS2 emulators. And that's the end of this video tutorial. Thank you for watching and have a good one.
Subscribe to DexTech Pro YouTube channel.